Hi all. Today I'm talking about a fungus coming under Ascomycotina aspergillus, Aspergillus. This is commonly known as black mold. It is a saprophytic fungus growing on decomposing organic matter. If you keep a wet bread for a couple of days, you might have noticed greenish or grayish smoky patches like this. And it includes the fungus Aspergillus along with some other fungus, Mucor, Rhizopus, etc. If you look into the structure of mycelium, it is well developed and made up of loosely interwoven mass of hyphae. The hyphae is septate, hyaline, bright or pale colored. The hyphae ramify superficially upon the substratum and also penetrate deeply into the substratum. It includes the homothallic as well as heterothallic species, that is, it producing sex organ on the same thallus as well as on the different thallus. If you look into the reproduction, it include vegetative, asexual and sexual method of reproduction. The vegetative reproduction is taking place through the fragmentation, and the asexual method is taking place through the conidia formation. The conidia are produced on the conidiophores. These are the conidiophores carrying the conidia. If you look into the development of the conidium, the conidiophores are developed on some specialized cell known as foot cell on the hyphae. These are known as foot cells. From the foot cell arises special erect branch or the outgrowth known as young conidiophore. The young conidiophore enlarges in length and the tip of the conidiophore forms a vesicle. And on this vesicle, the conidia are produced upon the stericmeta. You can see these green colored structures. These are known as stericmeta, singular sterigma. On these stericmeta, the conidia are produced. And based on the attachment of stericmeta upon the vesicle, there are two types of conidia known as uniseriate as well as the biseriate. In the case of uniseriate, the stericmata are directly attached to the vesicle like this. In this, the stericmata are directly attached to the vesicle. But in the case of biseriate condition, the stericmata is attached to the vesicle through a primary stericmata. This is known as primary stericma. And the stericma on which the conidia are attached is known as secondary stericma. The primary stericma is also known as metullae, metullae. There are two types of vesicle, that is uniseriate and biseriate. Now, coming on to the development of conidia. During the development of the conidia, the tip of the stericma enlarges to form a tube-like structure. Simultaneously, the single nucleus present in the stericma divides to produce two daughter nuclei. One of the daughter nuclei moves into the tube and a septa is developed and the tube is cut off, producing the first conidium. This is the first conidium. Later, a second conidium is developed just below the first conidium. In the same manner, this region will be producing the second conidium. Likewise, the third, fourth, and fifth conidia are produced on the same stericmeta. So, the first formed conidia will occupy the highest position. See, like this. This is the first formed conidia. And below that is the second formed conidia. And below that is the third conidia. And this type of arrangement is known as basipetal succession. Or basipetal arrangement. The conidia in the younger stages are connected with each other through a cytoplasmic connection known as isthmus. This is the cytoplasmic connection, and later the cytoplasm disappears and the connection is now known as connective. This is all about the development of conidia. Now, coming on to the sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction is a rare occurrence in the case of Aspergillus. I have told that it includes the homothallic as well as the heterothallic condition in the case of Aspergillus. That is, the sex organs are produced on the same thallus or on the different thallus. In this, the male reproductive branch is known as polynodium. Male reproductive branch is known as polynodium, polynodium. And the female reproductive branch is known as archicarp. The male reproductive structure is known as antheridium, and the female reproductive structure is known as ascogonium. The antheridium is produced upon the polynodium, and the ascogonium is produced upon the female reproductive hyphae known as archicarp. If you look into the structure of polynodium, see, this is the polynodium. It is having an apical multinucleate portion. This is known as antheridium. And below this multinucleate apical cell, there is a stalk cell or the basal cell. Both these stalk cell and the apical antheridial cell are multinucleate. In the case of archicarp, the archicarp is a spirally coiled structure having three regions. The apical region is known as the receptive hyphae or the trichogyne. This trichogyne is receiving the antheridium from the male branch. And below the trichogyne is the spirally coiled ascogonium. This is also multinucleate. And just below the ascogonium is the stalk cell. The entire structure is highly coiled. During the sexual reproduction, when the male polynodium and the female archicarp comes nearby, the polynodium slowly coil around the archicarp. Like this, the antheridium slightly, the polynodium slightly coil around the archicarp. When the antheridium reaches the trichogyne, the antheridium, suppose this is the antheridium, it reaches the trichogyne, it fuses with the trichogyne, and the wall of fusion get dissolved. wall of fusion get dissolved and the nucleus along with the cytoplasm migrate into the trichogyne. Finally, it reaches the ascogonium. Here, only plasmogamy is taking place, no karyogamy at all. Okay, during this developmental condition, the first developmental condition coming under the sexual reproduction, some sterile hyphae just below the ascogonium, just below the archicarp, produces a pseudo parenchymatous wall around this archicarp. Sterile hyphae grows around and produces a wall around it. This wall is known as peridium, and this entire structure is known as fruiting body. This is known as the fruiting body. The fruiting body is also known as ascocarp. It is a cleistothecium type, that is, the peridium is not at all having an opening. It is a completely closed structure, just like a ball. See, like this. This is known as ascocarp. The development of ascospores is taking place inside the ascocarp. The ascospore development is happening through the crozier formation. Through the crozier formation, this is a common feature seen in Ascomycotina. The ascogonium, actually the ascogonium is a spirally coiled structure, but for easy explanation, I am drawing like this. This is ascogonium, and ascogonium will be carrying both the male as well as the female nucleus. Soon after this dikaryotization, the septal wall is developed inside the ascogonium, producing the compartments. Each compartment will be carrying single male nucleus and single female nucleus. And from these compartments arises the ascogenous hyphae. These are the ascogenous hyphae. Each compartment produces the ascogenous hyphae like this. And this ascogenous hyphae will be having the male as well as the female nucleus. This is the ascogenous hyphae. The tip of the ascogenous hyphae enlarges and it slightly curve like this, producing a hook known as the crozier. Simultaneously, the male and the female nucleus undergo a division, producing two daughter nuclei. After this division, the septum is produced. This is the septum producing three cells. This is the apical cell, this is the penultimate cell, and this is the stalk cell. Penultimate cell develops into the assay. The penultimate cell is known as the ascus mother cell. This is the ascus mother cell. The nucleus in the ascus mother cell fuses and forms a diploid nucleus. After that, it undergo reduction division followed by mitotic division, producing eight daughter nuclei. Then the ascus mother cell enlarges, and forms the assay. The assay will be carrying eight nucleus. These eight nucleus are developing into the ascospores, eight ascospores. Once the ascospores are released into the substratum, it develops into new hyphae. This is all about the life cycle of Aspergillus. Happy learning. Wish you all the best. Bye.